Did you know that just one workout can transform your ability to focus? If you're living with ADHD, this isn't just interesting science, it could be a game changer for you. I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I make mental health education videos to help you strengthen your mind, fortify your brain, and build resilience. In our previous videos, we explored how exercise reshapes your brain and compared different types of movement. Today, we're focusing on a specific application, how exercise can be a powerful tool for managing ADHD symptoms. Let's start by understanding what's happening in the ADHD brain and how exercise can make a difference. One of the key players in ADHD is dopamine, a neurotransmitter that controls your attention, motivation, and reward. In ADHD, there's often a dysregulation of dopamine, and here's where exercise comes in. Physical activity boosts dopamine production and release in the brain. This increase in dopamine can help improve your focus and attention. Regular exercise can lead to long-term improvements in dopamine signaling. What do I mean by dopamine signaling? I don't want you to miss this point. Signaling refers to the complex process of how dopamine transmits information between your nerve cells. You see, ADHD is not just about having too little dopamine, it's about how effectively your brain uses it. Think of dopamine like a key, and your brain cells have special locks, which are the receptors that this key fits into. In ADHD, there can be problems with both the keys and the locks. Either the keys don't quite fit right, or there aren't enough working locks to receive the signal. This is why ADHD affects your brain's reward pathway and makes it harder to maintain attention and control impulses. Exercise helps by not only producing more dopamine, but also by improving how well your brain responds to it, like upgrading both the keys and the locks at the same time. Norepinephrine is another important transmitter that is negatively affected in ADHD. Exercise temporarily increases norepinephrine, which enhances alertness and cognitive performance during and shortly after you've exercised. This temporary boost from exercise can improve sustained focus and attention during tasks. These chemical boosts are paired with changes in your brain structure, specifically in the prefrontal cortex. The prefrontal cortex is your brain's command center, and it's often underactive if you have ADHD. Exercise increases blood flow and activity to the prefrontal cortex. This enhanced activation can improve executive functions like planning and impulse control. Over time, regular exercise may strengthen the prefrontal cortex connections. Not all exercise is created equal when it comes to ADHD. Let's look at how different types of physical activity can target specific ADHD symptoms. Aerobic exercise, like running or cycling, offers significant benefits for managing ADHD symptoms, particularly sustained attention. Even a single bout of moderate intensity cardio can improve attention and cognitive performance for up to 2 to 3 hours after you've exercised. And this makes it a great tool to use before tasks that require a lot of focus or problem solving. For longer term benefits, regular sessions of moderate intensity cardio lasting 30 to 40 minutes are most effective. And this duration provides enough time to stimulate neurotransmitter release, including dopamine and norepinephrine, which enhance focus and motivation. Additionally, serotonin and endocannabinoids are boosted, helping to regulate mood and reduce stress. Serotonin helps stabilize mood and reduce anxiety, while endocannabinoids promote relaxation and counteract hyperactivity. So aerobic exercise can help manage both emotional and physical symptoms of ADHD. While cardio gets a lot of attention, strength training has unique benefits for ADHD, especially for impulse control. Resistance exercises like weightlifting or bodyweight exercises can improve your brain's ability to control impulses and stay focused. Imagine your brain has a pause button that helps you stop yourself from talking over someone, or focus on your work instead of checking your phone, or think before reacting in a heated moment. This pause button is what scientists call inhibitory control. It acts like your brain's brakes, helping you manage impulses and distractions. This is especially valuable if you have ADHD, where impulsivity often feels like pressing fast forward. resistance training helps you build the mental capacity to hit pause instead. And it does this by promoting the release of growth factors like IGF-1, which enhance brain cell growth and repair. Over time, these changes make it easier for you to stay on track, resist temptations, and make thoughtful decisions. And this effect is real. Even single sessions of moderate intensity resistance exercise has been shown to enhance cognitive function in the short term. One study showed that the effects lasted approximately 40 minutes afterwards. And remember, consistency is key. Regular resistance training over time can lead to more stable improvements in your brain's pause button function. If you have ADHD, you know that starting and sticking to new habits can be challenging. Here's how to make it easier. For children with ADHD, the key is making movement fun and varied. Think playground activities, martial arts, or dance classes. Keep the sessions short. 15 to 20 minutes is perfect. Use movement breaks during homework time to maintain focus. For teens and adults, start with small 10-minute movement sessions. Gradually build up to 30 minutes as it becomes easier. Mix cardio and strength training to keep things interesting. While many find morning exercise beneficial, the best time to exercise is whenever it fits consistently into your routine. Experiment with timing to discover what works for you. If you decide to work out in the evening, make sure you finish at least 90 minutes before bedtime so it doesn't delay the time that you want to fall asleep. Also, you should consult with your healthcare provider before starting a new routine if you have medical conditions that could limit your exercise capacity. One of the biggest challenges with ADHD is maintaining consistency. Let's break down some practical strategies for this. First, start tiny. Begin with just 5 minutes of movement. It might not seem like much, but it's enough to start creating positive changes in your brain. Celebrate these small wins. They're the building blocks of bigger changes. Second, make it engaging. Leverage your interests to make exercise more appealing. If you love music, try dance-based workouts. For nature enthusiasts, look at hiking or running trails. If you're tech savvy, you may enjoy fitness apps or virtual reality workouts. Third, timing matters. Morning exercise can improve your focus for your daytime activities, but if mornings don't work for you, that's okay. Take movement breaks between tasks. Even brief exercise sessions before a challenging work can make a difference in how you're able to get through that work. Now let's match specific exercises to common ADHD challenges. If focus is your main struggle, try 20 minutes of moderate cardio before important tasks. For hyperactivity, strength training or high-intensity interval training can help channel some of that energy. If impulsivity is an issue, activities requiring precise movements like martial arts or yoga can be particularly beneficial. Here's some encouraging news. The benefits of exercise on ADHD symptoms can be both immediate and long-lasting. A single session can improve focus for several hours. But regular exercise does even more. It creates lasting changes in your brain structure and function, enhancing attention and impulse control over time. It's important to note that exercise isn't meant to replace other ADHD treatments. It's an effective tool to add to your management strategy. The key is finding ways to move that you can enjoy and sustain. In our next video, we'll explore how mindful movement can boost your overall mental resilience. But for now, start thinking about how you can add more general movement into your daily routine. Even small changes can make significant differences in managing your ADHD symptoms. Thanks for watching today. Remember to subscribe and hit the notification bell if you don't want to miss the next video in this series. See you next time.